I'm sure Haman wished, perhaps hoped and prayed, that Brock and Roman would not come face to face. Well, Roman came out to a whole lot of jeers, and then Brock showed right up after the thunderous cheers. They came face to face, and Haman looked like he would explode. Well, the Usos got suplexed and stared right up at their toes. Roman looked at his counsel and said, "You're on your own." And then Brock looked right at Haman. He knew he was boned. He got picked up for an F5, but Roman said, "Not so fast." He hit him with the Superman punch. It was over in a flash. Well, the Usos are looking at him like they're ready to pounce. But Brock said to you, "I'm gonna have you for lunch. Roam if you want to, roaming around the world." I'm John Rytham with my review of WWE SmackDown from Madison Square Garden. Horrible butchering of B-52's Roam. But yeah, let's just go on with that. Let me know your thoughts on this show in the comments. Of course, the show does start off on a somber note with 9/11 tributes 20 years ago tomorrow. Terrible tragedy that took so many lives, infected so many other lives, and such a terrible goddamn tragedy. So fucking goddamn sad. I vividly remember being at home seeing that, and I don't remember much more after that. In fact, a lot of that week after I saw the news was a goddamn blur. It just absolutely is. And well, WWE did their own tribute and apparently did their own documentary talking about the post 9/11 SmackDown they did on their YouTube channel. And I'm sure that they mentioned the Stephanie McMahon ill-advised comments because she suffered so much harsher loss because her family was involved in the steroid trial. And that compares to the deaths of so many goddamn, you know, human lives. Anyway, so yeah, this show started off with, Pat McAfee's back, so at least they have one proper commentator, not Michael Cole, who is really bad at his job. He is really fucking bad. Roman comes out to hit the MSG spot after getting head at the table. You know who you are is thinking about this, so don't even try to deny it. So the crowd was thrilled. You know, I did like how Roman took a subtle shot, said, you know, when it comes to sports entertainment, WWE wins New York, right? Because, of course, you know, AEW's got their Arthur Ashe Stadium coming up in a couple weeks. You know what? Healthy jabs like that are fine. That's fine. And MSG is the Mecca, of course. So much rich history there in WWE. So, and I mean, wrestling in general, but especially WWE. I mean, hell, G1 Supercard was there. So here's Bork. And man, you know, if he had his own bread company, he would be the yeast incarnate. Have fun unseeing that. So anyway, Heyman's trying to play Peacemaker. That was a terrible movie with Denzel Washington, by the way. And Brock says, "Why didn't you tell Roman I'd be at SummerSlam?" Ooh, scandalous. Heyman then, well, he's all like thrown off and everything. Roman's like leaving. He's like, "Well, okay, you fucking betrayed me. That's all the information I need." Heyman tries to do the advocate thing. And then Brock says he wants a shot. You've got 5 seconds. And he won't even do it. So he picks him up for an F5. And then Roman tries to fist him, of course. Because fisting a brick solid, you know, slab of beef is always going to go well. Even when you're a tribal chief getting head at the table. So yeah, the suplexes of the Usos, that was kind of goddamn funny. And that was pretty much it. Backstage, Roman is pissed. And then Heyman is upset by Kayla. Saying, like, a Jersey girl, you just pop up anywhere or whatever. Did Kayla really need the jacket for her interviews? I'm just going to say that. So, this was a terrific opening segment. Yeah, Brock versus Roman, it's not an entirely fresh match, but you know what? A face Brock and a heel Roman? That could work. Especially an actual heel Roman and not, like, the crowd wanting him to go heel because they were sick of how he was being pushed. And then, Sami Zayn, Otis, Ziggler, Rude, and Apollo with Aziz and Gable. No, you don't even have the good one of the Alpha Academy in the ring. You have Majin Buu taking on Big E, Rey, Dominik, Nakamura, and Boogs. So, here, Sami was in Nick's gear and pajama pants for whatever reason. Sami's got to be the next one to go. I cannot imagine that he's going to stick around unless his contract runs for another couple years. So, first, Sami brought out some guy named Trey Young to be in their corner. I want to say right now that apparently he's an NBA player. I had to be told this. I haven't watched the NBA in a while. Apparently, he helped eliminate the New York Knicks from the conference finals, I believe. The Atlanta Hawks. You know, he's on the Atlanta Hawks. Okay, whatever. And the guy seemed like he was happy to be there, and he did some stuff. And it was what it was. This match, it was fine. It was fine. It was just a match. Just a match was there. Big ending to Sami 1-2-3. There wasn't a lot to this particular match. So anyway, Kayla's talking, And, you know, talking to, talking to Big E afterwards, and he says, if you have what I want, have what I need, I'm coming for your neck. Just like, June 23rd and 24th, 2007. Man, fucking going to hell for that one. So here's Bianca, and we go to break. Then we get more 9/11 clips. All right, so we get the SmackDown Women's Championship contract signing. Bianca gets a pop, and she knocks Becky a bit and everything, that kind of stuff. Like, you know, no excuses. I lost, but this time I'm going to be ready. All right, typical babyface promo. Here's Becky in a fur coat and nothing else, just a fur coat. The original main, you know, Women's Mania main event is here. But then Bianca says mine was better. She's not wrong. Bianca and Sasha was a ton better than Ronda, Charlotte, and Becky, mainly because we want to see Becky and Ronda. This is shortly after, by the way, Ronda said about Sasha, what does she want me to do? Cut off my hair and wash her feet with it. I'm never going to forget that. And, well, what if I don't sign this contract, Becky says. She's going back and forth and all this, and the crowd's changed, sign, and then Becky goes with the typical, you know, cheap heel, you people. What do you mean, you people? Fox must have mandated the you people thing since, you know, Bianca's right there. By the way, the way Bianca's dressed, I actually knew a girl in college that had pearls on her ears just like that. I can't say how. That's all I'm going to say, though. So anyway, have fun on seeing that, by the way. So, yeah, they did their stuff, and I will say the contract catching was kind of cool. That was kind of nice. Bianca, I really hope that this works with Bianca, because Bianca's very over. I don't think this heel Becky thing's going to work. She's going to try, but people are still going to cheer her. They're booing her there, but it's going to be select markets. So Edge got a huge reaction, wanted it all from the fans or everything. And he's wearing pink and black. Good tribute there. Tribute to Bret, obviously, you know, Bret who is still around. And Owen Hart, you know, tribute to the Harts, really good stuff, Canadian heritage. And then Heyman is, he's possibly going to have to get a ride. And Shotzi and Tegan are just there, back there in a tank. That is the extent of what else they did with the women tonight. More on that later. Kayla popping up like Slender Man. And just, you know, she is enjoying this. She is really enjoying needling Heyman. I mean, she's enjoying poking him. I would like, never mind, I would not like to poke Kayla. How dare anybody accuse me of that? And Big E was just laughing, because of course he is. Rollins versus Edge, SummerSlam rematch. Let me just say right now, very well-wrestled match. Pay-per-view worthy shit. Here's the problem. They didn't format this show properly, and apparently since this match went really, 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 really long, I believe it was Liv and Toni Storm against Carmella and Zelina that got cut. Now, I'm 50-50 on Zelina and Carmella, in all honesty, when it comes to stuff in the ring. But Toni, I like to see in the ring, and I also think that Liv deserves more of a shot. Zelina also lost her father in 9/11. So that would have at least been nice for her to be able to wrestle there. So hopefully they had a dark match or something like that. You know, maybe Ford and Tully just send that out and send the crowd home happy and she could work in that venue. You still should have probably had on TV. People could say it's nitpicking, but it's a 2-hour show and there are certain things they didn't need to have go that long. So that's just my take. But, you know, in all honesty, especially for Zelina, but just for the women in general. Like, they have enough women. I mean, even if Carmella's going to be there, okay, whatever. She could take the pin because that's really all she'd be doing is, you know, taking the pin 1, 2, 3. What else can she do? Well wrestled, and you know, I did like the pink black ear on Edge. Were two glam slams by Seth, and oh no, he's using the wife's move. God forbid, we're gonna get Beth versus Seth. That's hard to say at the Royal Rumble. Beth is gonna be in the men's Royal Rumble and eliminate Seth Rollins. Watch it happen. Why, for no reason. So anyway, pedigree by Edge for two. Canadian crossface and to the ropes. Man, if only ropes were around there in Atlanta. Moving on. Buckle bomb to Edge. That's just what you do. I mean. And it wasn't even Seth's fault, but just they need to take the buckle bomb out. They just need to take it out in general. Spear out of nowhere for two. Unseen low blow. Kick, 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 punch. It's all in the mind. Why won't you die? That's good to say. And then the stomp. 1, 2, 3. And man, just Edge is just motionless. Really selling this stuff well. I have not seen a Canadian wrestler that motionless in 5,191 days. So, Edge was being taken to a local medical facility for neck issues and anal bleeding. What? Wow. So Rollins was confused and also being interviewed by, I don't know who the hell that woman was. She's in a red dress. She kind of reminded me of Mila Jovovich from the beginning of, part of Resident Evil 1. Anyway, Roman and Heyman, I saved you. Why didn't you tell me that Brock was going to be at SummerSlam? And there we go. And then we have, it's smoke season, fam, says Pat. And then, So we basically have a, we have enough cups or whatever for the women to team up on every single one of them. It's going to be two women, one of many cups to choose from. So, Profits and Usos had a SmackDown Tag Team Championship match. It was well wrestled. We had the entrances, 2 minutes of action and break. Montez is going to end up braining himself on one of those dives. I hope he doesn't. And then Roman shows up. The pace is good. And basically, right as it looked like Montez was going to hit the From the Heavens splash for three, he hit the splash, and then Roman causes a DQ, choking out the African-American man once again, a Fox mandate. And then he says that Brock wants it, he'll get it. And then suddenly, spoopy lighting and the big old red sun that was going to come down, you know, one of the Final Fantasy movie, or no, games, not Final Fantasy Spirits Within. Anyway, let's move on from that. It's Demon Finn. Holy shit, nobody saw that coming. Demon Finn's going to lose to Roman at Extreme Rules. I mean, I'll be very shocked if they have Finn win. Finn for the win. So, it was cool. I hate to say it. I think you could just save it for the pay-per-view. I mean, it is what it is. They don't have to promote pay-per-views anymore because it's all on the cock. We get a demon cock. That will be the second biggest demon cock that I've seen on the internet. Always delete your search history. And with that, let me know your thoughts in the comments. Like, share, subscribe, Twitter handle in the description. I'm John Rithlin. I'll see you soon.